know what else is remarkable? The two ends of the surah, both of them deal with salah. When do you recite Quran? Iqra. Where do you recite Quran? In salah. Where do you make sajda? In salah. What is the means by which you get close to Allah? When is the slave closest to Allah? In sajda, in salah. So the beginning is worship, the end is worship. The other beautiful thing about this, that how the surah is tied together, is the first part, the first commandment was to read, which is a commandment to seek knowledge, right? Reading enhances your knowledge. But the ending, usjud waqtarib, these are commandments of worship. So there are two things, right? There's seeking knowledge and there's worship. And you know, so there's talabul ilm and there's qira'ah, that's on the one hand. Then there's ibadah on the other. But what comes first? First you learn, then you worship. There's this gradation between knowledge and then action. And this is something in the entire Quran. First you learn, then you practice. Then you learn, then you practice, right? So seeking of knowledge and then practicing that knowledge. Iqra in the beginning, usjud waqtarib at the end. This is, you know, Quran is not meant to be just, uttered in hyper speed. You have no idea what's being recited and you just got it over with. That's not what Quran came down for. And that's the last activity which will give you khushu' in the salah. And the whole point of the salah is what? Remembering Allah. أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي, Allah says. Establish salah so you can remember me. How are you remembering Allah if you can't even keep up with the word? You can't even keep up, you don't even know what's being recited. How are you remembering Allah? So we've lost the spirit of the prayer and we're more concerned with the form of the prayer, and that's unfortunate. But that's, again, it's a side subject. Let's come to the surah itself, inshallah ta'ala, and finish as much as we possibly can. When Allah accepts tawbah, He doesn't just forgive your sins. What does He do? He takes your evil deeds and replaces them with good ones. This is the nature of tawbah. It's a very powerful act of Allah's mercy, and it's an extreme act of Allah's love. You find in the Quran, atubu, I accept tawbah, I. Tawbah is extreme mercy, I. Not we, but I. When it comes to extreme punishments in the Quran, for example, when the followers of Isa alayhi salam asked Him to send a table spread from the sky. Right? They asked Him for a table spread from the sky. Isa alayhi salam's first response, ittaqullah. Fear Allah, have taqwa of Allah. What are you asking for? And this is appropriate for Isa alayhi salam because he is the last of the messengers to Bani Israel, and they've been asking for miracles for generations. And after seeing the most amazing things, they still don't have iman. Their hearts are still hard. So now you're still asking for a table spread? You're still asking for a miracle to see? Allah Azza wa Jal did say He's sending it down, but He sent a warning with it. And what's the warning? If anybody disbelieves after this, فَإِنِّي أُعَذِّبُهُ عَذَابًا لَا أُعَذِّبُهُ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ, then it is I who will torture him with a torture for sure that I have never tortured anyone with. Very strong language, and the strength of the language becomes even tougher because of what word? I, instead of we. So there's a difference between how they're used in the Quran. But one last point that is not commonly noted and is very important to note, it's beautiful about the Quran. People who get confused about the use of the word we in the Quran don't read Quran carefully enough. Whenever the word nahnu occurs for subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, right after or right before, either there's the word Allah or there's the word Rabb. Both what for version? Singular. So it's never confusing that is it really plural or is it one? Immediately the singular form is used. For example, even in this surah, inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr, right? But then as you go forward, you'll find the word Rabb. You'll find, and we'll discover it, inshallah ta'ala. Okay? How did Allah teach His Sahaba, the Sahaba of the Messenger? How did Allah teach His Messenger Himself? How many years did it take to learn the Quran? On occasion, 23 years. The occasion is coming, the ayat, the lessons are coming. And they're being internalized little by little by little. So we learn from that. Quran is a long-term study. Even for ourselves, that's even part of the sunnah. The Quran is not something you can just casually just read through it like you read a newspaper or you finish a textbook. I read the Quran. You can't do that with the Quran. It takes time to internalize. It's something deep. It requires deep study, right? So this, the word anzalna, for the first heaven. And from there, down to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, over the next 23 years. Found in a hadith, this is from many athar of the Sahaba. The gist of it is called Laylatul Qadr because the word Qadr means estimation, determination also. Determination. Allah Azza wa Jal Himself, you know, He is Wallahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. Same root, same root. Allah has estimate and control over everything. But you know how there's a 30-year plan or a million-year plan, but then there's a year's budget, right? Or the actions that need to be taken for that year. In Lata'if al-Isharat, this is actually something really beautiful Al-Fushayri rahimahullah wrote in the 4th century. I want to share the quote with you. في ليلة قدر فيها الرحمة لأوليائه. First of all, it is a beautiful night in which Allah decreed mercy for His close friends. May Allah make us from them. يجد فيها العابدون قدر نفوسهم. The worshippers of Allah realize the worth of their own selves in this night. Qadr again, the qadr of their own selves, meaning the appreciation of their own selves. What that means is the people who take advantage of this night, they realize what they are worth to Allah. Because if you're not worth anything to Allah, you'll sleep through it. You won't take any advantage of it. Okay. So the ones who really appreciate Allah find what they are worth to Allah in this night. Qadr nufusihim. وَيَشْهَدُ فِيهَا الْعَارِفُونَ قَدْرَ مَعْبُودِهِمْ. And those who really seek to recognize Allah, they appreciate the one that they're worshipping in this night. They really find an appreciation of Allah like no other night in this night. Allah knows everything already, but He lets His angels know of what the plan is for this year. What is Allah decreed for the people for this year? He informs the angels of that in this night. So for that year, basically the execution of Allah's plan is dedicated or is delivered to the angels in Laylatul Qadr. That's the first thing for that next year. وَقِيلَ إِنَّهَا سُمِّيَتْ بِذَلِكَ لِعَظِيمِ قَدْرِهَا وَشَرْفِهَا. This is the other thing. Qadr not just means estimation, calculation, precision. It also means honor, nobility, dignity. So it's called the night of great dignity and nobility also because of its great nobility. Then, and Az-Zahri calls it that too. وَقِيلَ سُمِّيَتْ بِذَلِكَ لِأَنَّ لِلطَّاعَاتِ فِيهَا قَدْرًا عَظِيمًا. This is beautiful. And it's called the night of appreciation. Qadr is also to appreciate. And it says that the Mufassirun say, it's called this night because in this night when people obey Allah, Allah really appreciates it. That this is the night of Allah appreciating the worship of and the ibadah of His slave. And obviously, so appreciated it is that He counts this one night's worship as how many? 1,000 months, right? So 1,000, الألف خيرٌ من ألف, better, more than 1,000 months. So it's not even, it is 1,000 months, it is better than 1,000 months. So he went even further than 1,000 months, subhanAllah. Then finally, وَقِيلَ الْخَلِيلِ سُمِّيَتْ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لِأَنَّ الْأَرْضِ تَضِيقُ فِيهَا بِالْمَلَائِكَةِ. The word qadr in Arabic has one more meaning that's also used in the Quran, and that is constriction, congestion, to be stuck in something. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, for example, in Surah Al-Talaq, He says, وَمَنْ قُدِرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقُهُ. Whoever his provision became tight on him, meaning their budget became tight, right? We also read in Juz Amma before, وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقُهُ. Right? Whoever we test and we take his risk and we make it tight, their budget becomes constrained. They don't have as loose an opportunity to spend cash anymore. It becomes restrictive on them. So this tightness, liq, is also part of the meaning of qadr. And it's called that also, that meaning is injected in it also, because so many angels descend on the earth that space becomes tight, subhanAllah. All of these meanings of the nobility of the night, the decree of the night, also qadr means power also, so the power of the night, then the tightness because of the descent of all those angels, all of these meanings are embedded in one word. Now if you take any of these, any alternatives of qadr, if you say laylat al-sharf, the night of nobility, then all the other meanings are gone. If you say the night of, you know, power, then all the other meanings are gone. But Allah Azza wa Jalla picked the perfect word which captures all these beautiful implications all at the same time without compromising the integrity of the meaning, subhanAllah. So Al-Biqa'i rahimahullah, he says, again, just commenting again on the who, he says it is an indication that the love of the Qur'an and the recognition of the Qur'an lies in every heart. That's why it is enough to say. وَمَا أَضْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. Another interesting comment about مَا أَضْرَاكَ. They're amazing language. If we just get to finish مَا أَضْرَاكَ, I think I'll be happy for this evening, inshallah ta'ala. First of all, مَا in Arabic is used for many purposes. One of them is التعجب, to give you a sense of awe, okay? To make you, to surprise you even. One of the, I think, to give you a sense of how this should be translated, what in the world could possibly make you realize? What in the world could possibly give you a clue what Laylatul Qadr really is? What it really is. Now it's different from saying when it is. See, all of our discussion has become what about Laylatul Qadr? When is it? But what's the question Allah is highlighting? Not when is it, but what is it? What do you realize what amazing thing this is? What you have before you? This is mal al-ta'ajjub. This is one. With tafkheem also to give it gravity. To you understand this is a very strong subject, very heavy thing.